That you're in a cabaret, perhaps in Europe. Well, it is thanks to the music of Monica Wall. Monica, you paint a picture so incredible. Words cannot describe, but your music says it all.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so now let's get right into it. The whole type and genre that you sing is unique here. We don't get a lot of it.
Yes, it took me a long time actually to find a definition for it. And I'm calling it vintage cabaret and chamber pop. It's sort of a little bit of both of those, so yeah.
And your musical background, training?
I did a bachelor's degree here in Winnipeg, and then I went to the US and did a master's degree in vocal performance there. And then I moved to Europe and I did some private studies there.
Yes, so you moved to Europe, Germany, with your family. Mm-hmm. How did that make an influence on your music?
Oh, I think it's influenced the music quite a bit. If you listen to my music, I think a lot of it has a very European kind of sound to it. Mm-hmm. And so it's influenced it in that way. It also influenced it in the way that I didn't write my own music until I came back from Germany. So it had that transition time happened while I was in Germany, where I moved from, I'd originally learned classical music and opera, mm-hmm. and transitioned into doing more jazz and spirituals and popular music of different kinds. And then when I came back, the songs started to come.
Wow. Okay, so the song that you performed, the story behind it,
oh,
Angelo.
Yeah, yes. Angelo is actually a real person who lives here in Winnipeg. You're in our home. So this is when we moved back from Germany. Our house was quite old, and so we needed to do some fix up on it. And so there was an older man came in who, from Angelo's Glass, so you can all look that up. He's a wonderful worker. And he had this wonderful spirit about him. Just a really lovely person, it seemed to me, even though he just came in and installed some mirrors in my home. But he had a lot of integrity and a lot of pride in his craft. And he told me he had been doing this for 50 years. So if you can imagine doing any job for 50 years, that was quite remarkable to me. And so he really had an influence on me. And then I started to write the song, and I started to think about how the people that where he had installed the mirror when he was young, mm-hmm. had in the meantime grown old.
Oh.
Right, so sort of the passing of these lives, mm-hmm. all these lives that he had touched with his mirror, and you know how you look in the mirror and you see the changes over time. And so the changes can be physical, but also sometimes there can be a sense of losing your spring in your step and losing your sense of center and who you are can happen. It doesn't mm-hmm. always, but it sometimes does. And Angelo didn't have any of those issues. He had that spring in his step, he had that youthful spirit. And so I thought about all those people and sort of also whether they all had maintained this integrity that Angelo had maintained.
Oh. Oh, it's so beautiful. And now you're about to share it with others. Now you have a show coming up on Saturday.
Yes, on September 22nd, which is this coming Saturday, I will be doing a show at the West End Cultural Center. And joining me will be Red Moon Road, who are a fantastic folk roots band. I'm very excited to be having them open the show as well. They will be joining us during my set, so that will be a real treat too.
Yes, and fabulous. And a new CD out, Parallel Mondo?
Parallel Mondo, yes. Parallel Mondo came as a result of this experience that I had living in Europe, mm-hmm. and then coming back and realizing, you know, my life in Europe, all my friends, their lives were continuing, and my life was continuing here, and how we were living these parallel lives, and also how the people who had been living here in Canada while I was gone had, you know, I sort of missed things. Like, I'd come back and it's like, oh, I never heard of that movie, or I, you know, missed political events and things like that because they weren't reported in Europe. And so it made me realize that we all are living in these parallel worlds all the time. And so the concept of that, when I wrote the songs, it wasn't a conscious thing, but when I looked at them later as a group, they all sort of reference this idea of different worlds happening at the same time. So.
Yes, and you magically work it in your music. This is Monica Wall. Get her new album, Parallel Mondo, but better yet, go see her in person at the West End Cultural Center this Saturday. For Backstage, I'm Tracy Copa.